Dear students, today we will see the formation of compound C. It is heating system. This is tripod stand. This is burner, gas burner. This is, you know, wire gauge. I am putting over here. Wire gauge is used to regulate the heat. Now I am taking sulfur, you know, sulfur. And sulfur, you know, it is of yellow color. Just I am taking here. A little amount of sulfur. See the sulfur. Sulfur has, you know, light yellow color. Here I am keeping. Now I have iron fillings. This I am taking the iron fillings, and I am see the iron fillings I am putting here. Now again I am taking little amount of iron. See, it is homogeneous. It is homogeneous mixture. Now, this is mixture. But you know, there is the reaction. Reaction takes place. Sufficient amount of sulfur has to mix together. And see, there is the formation. So, just keep it here. Now, as it is being heated, so it will be converted into iron sulfide. I have taken Fe, and there is sulfur, and there is the formation of iron sulfide. Slowly and slowly, reaction will take place. Just no heat, uniform heating. Initially, now it is having the heterogeneous character. Now it will be converted into homogeneous. Slowly and slowly, see the homogeneous nature. Reaction is being, see the change in color. Change in color. Now, initially it was heterogeneous, but due to reaction, see children, there the reaction we can see. See the bubbles. It means chemical reaction is going on. See carefully. Formation of bubbles by heating. And see the heterogeneous have been converted into homogeneous. Now see reaction. Reaction is taking place, and then there is the formation of FeS. Formation of FeS. See, the heterogeneous has converted to homogeneous. So it is called as formation of compound by reaction between sulfur and iron. This is compound FeS. Now, just you have seen. Actually, here the reaction, iron solid and sulfur solid, it on heating, there is formation of iron sulfide, there is formation of iron sulfide. So, I have mixed, you know, some amount of sulfur, some amount of iron powder, and so on heating. So, here, as per the stoichiometry, as per the ratio, it is one part, and it is also one part. And there is formation of this compound, in which there is the ratio of iron to sulfur is 1:1. Both are equal. Now, this is one aspect. But when we mix iron and sulfur, it forms mixture. Now, mixture is heterogeneous. And you know, you have seen in previous lecture, the mixture can be separated by magnet. But here, this iron sulfide, as it is homogeneous. It is homogeneous in nature. So, the mixtures and the compounds, they differ a lot. This can be separated by magnet. The components of iron and sulfur, they can be separated by magnet. See again, this is, you know, heterogeneous, and we can use the magnet to separate here. We can use, see the iron particles, they have been separated by, and sulfur has been left. Now, on the other hand, we cannot separate. See how. Now see, what I have written earlier on. See, its homogeneous nature. It is homogeneous. It is uniform throughout. This is, you know, this is non-uniform. It is uniform. Now, when I am moving the magnet. Now, it is not able to attract. It is not able to attract. See carefully. Just I am moving over it. It is not being attracted. Why? Because the iron has been converted into compound, and in a compound the properties are changed. In a compound the properties are changed. And as a result, we say that compound cannot be separated into components easily. We can separate, but here it can be separated. So this is about the formation of compound and its comparison with the mixture.